Israel marked Holocaust Martyrs and Heroes Remembrance Day in memory of the 6 million Jews killed by the Nazis in World War II, as well as those who fought back. But this year's ceremonies came as reports said anti-Semitism is once again on the rise worldwide. Sirens blared, calling Israel to a halt for 2 minutes in honor of the memory of the 6 million Jews murdered in the Holocaust.
It's our first time being here during the Holocaust Memorial, and it was very powerful. It was something that we've never seen, and that everybody groups together as a country, which was pretty amazing.
I was praying for peace and everything, and I was thinking about all of the Holocaust and the victims.
All the world, we need to remember this day, but I'm very sad that every day I think the memory is going and going down, so my children don't know nothing about the Holocaust.
These brothers from California said they didn't study about the Holocaust in school, but they knew what it was about.
We freeze because we're a member of the Jews that were in the war that died, so it doesn't happen again.
My dad just told me about it, and also I think of my great-grandmother, Bubby Ida, who survived the Holocaust.
Events began the previous night when the Israeli flag was lowered to half-mast at Yad Vashem's Holocaust Memorial in Jerusalem. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu and President Reuven Rivlin addressed the opening ceremony of Holocaust Martyrs and Heroes Remembrance Day. Both spoke about growing anti-Semitism and the need to fight it.
We live in a paradox today. The worldwide admiration for the Jewish state is accompanied in certain circles with the rise of hatred of Jews. The radical right, radical left, and radical Islamic groups agree on only one thing, hatred of Jews. This is not a legitimate criticism of Israel, but a systematic, poisonous, and shallow hatred that constantly undermines the legitimacy of the Jewish nation state and only the Jewish nation state.
Political forces where anti-Semitism and racism are part of their language, their legacy, or their ideology can never be our allies. There is no such thing as loving Israel and hating Jews, just like there is no such thing as loving Jews and hating Israel.
Israel remembers the Holocaust every year according to the Hebrew calendar on the anniversary of the 1943 Warsaw Ghetto Uprising. Though the Jewish fighters were almost all killed, it marked a shift in thinking from victim to fighter. Later, it helped shape Israel's national identity, symbolizing strength and the fight for freedom in the face of death. Alpha.